Hi guys, so this is going to be hopefully a fairly comprehensive build guide for the SAMCO Arduino powered infrared light gun. So firstly I'm just going to run you through the parts that you'll need for the project, then I'll show you a quick schematic, then the actual build guide, and then how to upload your code. So let's get into it. Firstly you will need a DF robot IR positioning camera, a microcontroller with built-in HID support. I'm using an Adafruit ItsyBitsy M0, two infrared LEDs, two 100 ohm resistors, an old USB cable. I've just used an old charging cable and cut the end off, and a fairly long USB micro cable. You also need a few tools, so you'll need some wire cutters, a Phillips screwdriver, some solder, I recommend 6040, and a soldering iron. So that's the absolute basics, but if you want to make your life a little bit easier, you can get yourself one of these. This is a little PCB board that I've created to just fit everything in nicely and just replace the insides of the Namco light gun with as little fuss as possible. I've got fritzing guides up of this on my GitHub, and I also have a few of these on my eBay if you want to purchase them. So if you use the PCB, you'll also just need a couple of extra things. So a little bit of extra wire, a thumbtack, this push button, which you can get from Adafruit, a drill, and a 3.5 millimeter drill bit. All right, so let's get into the schematic. So here we have our schematic. As you can see, it's a fairly simple design. We just have the DF robot IR positioning camera running off I2C. I've powered mine off pin 5, but you could just as easily power it off 3 volts. Then the rest of it's basically just a whole lot of switches. So I have a left mouse button, calibration pin, right mouse button, middle mouse button, and then I've also broken out another pin just in case you want to add an LED or something like that, but I don't actually use that in my code. Also, just a quick note, if you do want to use an 18Mega32U4 board, you'll just have to change these two pins because they are shared by the I2C. But if you're using the M0, then you don't have to worry about it. And then we also just have two infrared LEDs running off USB. So that's about that. Let's get into the build guide. Okay, so firstly, obviously, we'll have to open up our Namco light gun with just these few screws here. Once we have it opened, we can see what's going on inside. So we just need to trim these two red and white there, and then there's two little black ones up the top that you'll have to trim as well. Once you've done that, we can just lift out all the old circuitry. We don't actually need any of this anymore, so you can dispose of that. And then we just want to take out our little buttons here. So we just pull out that one, and then pull out this other one, and that'll just make it easier when we're soldering everything together. Okay, so just before we solder everything together, we just want to make a little hole for our calibration button right here. So how we do that is we grab the little calibration part of our PCB, and as you can see, it's got a little hole in between those four soldering points there. So we just have to flip that over, and then we push that into the corner here, and then we use our thumbtack just to mark the center of that button, which is what we'll use to as a point for drilling the hole for our calibration button. So once that's marked, simply grab your drill and just drill our little calibration button hole. All right, so now we have to just solder everything together. So I've made this little guide here, which will hopefully help. It's fairly self-explanatory. Just one thing you have to be a little bit careful with is what side you solder on. So if you can see in the diagram, there's some dotted lines, which mean insert your wires from the unprinted side of the board, and then the solid lines mean insert your wires to the printed side of the board, which you hopefully see here. So here we have it. It's all soldered together. Once you've got something looking pretty similar to this, all we have to do is populate it back into our gun, like so. Just be a little bit careful. I noticed when I filmed this, my IR positioning camera moved around a bit. Just make sure the little bit that says top in the little white circle is facing the top of the gun, not like mine does there. So if you've got that all right, then all we need to do now is upload our code. Okay, so just a couple of things we'll need to upload our code. Firstly, you'll need the Arduino IDE software if you haven't already got that installed. I'll leave a link below to where to get this from. Once that's installed, you'll also need to install the libraries from Adafruit for your ItsyBitsy M0 board. So once again, I'll leave a link to that. It's fairly self-explanatory, so I won't go into that too much. And then the last thing you'll need is the actual code, which you can get from here. This is my GitHub page. So simply go into IR Lightgun, download the file. Once that's downloaded, all we need to do is unzip it. So if we just go into downloads, unzip that, and then grab this folder here. And then we just simply need to drop that into our Arduino libraries, which on a Mac is under Arduino libraries and documents. Once that's all done, we can open up our code in the Arduino IDE. So here it is. Here is the code. It's almost ready to go. You only have to do one small tweak, which is scroll down to here and just change this to the resolution of your screen or the screen that you want to use your gun on. Mine's already set up, so I've got my gun plugged in and my two LEDs stuck to the top of my screen. So now all I have to do is make sure that I'm using the correct board, the ItsyBitsy M0. Make sure that I'm on the right port, and then simply click upload. So this will compile the sketch, make sure there's no errors, as you can see down the bottom there, and then it will start to upload. Should only take a couple of seconds. If you're on a Mac, you'll probably get this little notice come up here. Don't worry about that, you can just close that. All right, so now what we have to do is open our serial monitor. Just be aware, if you're doing this on Windows, your mouse may have been taken over by the light gun, but you can still open your serial monitor by pressing Control-Shift-M. So once you've got that open, you just want to move back from your screen a bit until you start seeing the raw numbers changing, as you can see here. And now we can give it a test. So if we press the calibration button, aim up into the top left, pull the trigger, aim to the bottom right, pull the trigger, our mouse should be working. You can check the mouse buttons are working. Move it around, you should be able to tilt it a little bit, you should be able to pause it by pressing the calibration button. Push the calibration button again and then pull the trigger, you should be able to recalibrate. And if that's all working, congratulations, you have your very own SAMCO Arduino powered infrared light gun. I do plan to make a few more videos, kind of setup guides to show you how to get these working on your favorite emulators. So if you don't want to miss out on that, please subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like. If you have any questions, just put them in the comments below and I'll try and get back to you. Once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Thanks a lot. Bye.